Mondays. For those of you who are new to my channel, please like, share, comment, subscribe, put on those notifications, all that great stuff. My family. I am so happy I'm back with another Medicine Monday video. I know it's been a while and I'm sorry, but your girl's been
stressed.
But can we just comment on my hair growth right now? Like,
oh, yeah! Thank God for the hair growth. But back to with that hair.
I just wanted to apologize for my absence these past couple of weeks because I just had to take a moment for myself. As you can see, with everything going on in the country, it's a lot of unsettling feelings regarding, you know, the racial injustice that is occurring, specifically with what happened with George Floyd and that unlawful murder. And so I just want to be able to use this Medicine Monday video to talk about mental health, what people of color specifically can do during this time that is, you know, very hard. And when you're trying to, you know, be very woke about the Black Lives Matter movement, but also carry on with your regular daily task, it can be difficult. Let me tell you, I feel like sometimes I'm on social media for more than 10 minutes and I'm crying at the next video that pops up on my screen showing police brutality. And it's very difficult because you want to educate yourself, right? But then you're also recognizing you're traumatizing your own mental health with all this scrutiny that you're seeing. But I want this video to be a coping mechanism for others so that they can use the tips that I've been using to help stay sane. And also just our white allies. I want to thank those who've been reaching out to me for letting me know that they stand by my side during this time. It means the world. And I know for them, it may be difficult to have uncomfortable conversations with their family members, but it's important, right? To educate not only yourself on what's going on, but your family members, because the fight for racial equality happens in your living room when you're, you know, dismantling those stereotypes that you held, when you're checking your own implicit bias. And so I just want this video to talk about the mechanisms that I've been doing to help me cope with this difficult time. All right, let's get into it. So first things first, making sure you are meeting your basic bodily needs. What does that mean? Well, I know right now social media is hot. We're on Twitter, we're on Instagram, we're on Facebook, we're on Snapchat, we're on TikTok. We're on our group chats, hopping from group chat to group chat, educating ourselves, talking about the next thing on Zoom calls, you know, trying to be woke, trying to be understanding, trying to, you know, find distractions. And during that time, we forget to eat. We don't use the bathroom. We go to bed at like 3 a.m. So it's super important that you take care of this body, this vessel. It needs your attention. Waking up at an appropriate time to have breakfast, fixing yourself some lunch, setting a time to make and create dinner. I love to cook, y'all. And so what I've been doing to help myself throughout this time is to distract myself through cooking, doing different recipes, right? Watching some home-cooked meals, going on YouTube and watching how to cook different recipes has been helpful. So just making sure that you are having 3 meals a day, that you are exercising if that's what you regularly do, that you are reading your Bible if that's something that you do. I love reading my scriptures. And so that's something that I do every morning and try to do every night. And so making sure that you stay in tune with your regular habits that you usually do and don't get so caught up in social media and so caught up in these different group chats where you don't have time for yourself. Which brings to my second point. Make sure that you have created a diet of the type of content that you are accepting through social media. Right now, specifically for Black people, social media for me is draining. I get on there and like I said, I cry within the next 10 minutes if I find a video that resonates with me and it, you know, it hits a spot. I see a quote that literally I'm like, wow, I can't believe that Black people are facing this right now, you know? And so it's important that you digest things that are healthy and that you're not always taking everything in at once. I think it's super important that you set a timer of how much time you spend on social media. Maybe it's twice a day for 30 minutes, right? You don't want to always take in so much negative content. And it's not like it's bad, but it's hard for people of color to watch other people of color die just because of their skin. And so making sure that you are very self-conscious of the type of content that you are taking in as a Black individual. Third thing that you should be doing is finding your community during this time. It's super important that you have a friend group that you can go and rely on, that you can laugh with, because You need some laughs during these times that are difficult, right? Like you're marching, you're protesting, you're speaking, you're crying, you're trying to educate. It's okay to be happy during those times too, to be with your friends of color and just this relate and vent and to talk with. It's super important to find a community during this time, y'all. When I tell you, your friends get it, they understand what you're going through, reach out to them, reach out to your family members. If you need a vent, go and vent. You know, which brings to my fourth point, that a lot of people are gonna be
like, what?
Be involved in your feelings. What I mean is sit in that pain. If you feel like you wanna cry, if you are angry, if you are frustrated, if you are working from home and you're like, I just need some time to just cry it all out, do that. Sit in that pain. Understand how it's making you feel, because only you and you only know the impact it's having on your body. And so for me, what I've done is, you know, go into my poetry. I just write out and try to express my feelings on paper. And that's how I got my I'm Tired video. And as you can see, I was super emotional. I just let my feelings out there. And it was such a relieving moment for me, because I'm like, yes, I'm in pain. Let me feel that pain. Let me cry. Crying is super healthy. It doesn't mean you're weak. It means you're strong and you're human, because you're feeling emotions that are real. So it's super important, y'all, that you are sitting in those feelings and understanding how they're impacting your body. All right, are we on the fourth point or the fifth point? Whatever point we're on, next things next is set boundaries to the people that you are engaging with right now. Because let me tell you, although there may be 100 people agreeing with what you're saying, want to understand, want to learn, are standing by your side, there's 10 people out there that want to... that don't get it, and they are
ignorant, they are insensitive, they don't care
about what's going on, and they just try to push back and they just try to argue. And so my advice is, set boundaries with the people you want to engage with during this time, right? It's not your job to educate people on what's going on. As a Black person, you live this life, right? And trying to explain and share your story could be tiring. I do believe it's our job to inspire those to want to learn more. And if you want, you can go the extra step and sit down and have conversation. But for those people who are just negative, who are just in your DMs, who just want to fight, who are saying,
Black on Black crime is more of a danger, drug on drugs, blah, blah, blah.
I don't got time for that. Let me tell you, you are blocked, deleted, reported, restricted, all that jazz. I had someone come in my DMs at 3 a.m. and I don't know why I was up, but I was up.
And I had time.
I gave them 5 minutes of my time, and when I recognized that they had no intention of understanding my perspective and actually just wanted to break down my content and really just destroy who I am as an individual.
Blocked, reported, deleted, all that jazz.
You have to only allow positive energy in your life. You are in control of the people that you get to interact with. You know what I mean? Like, it's a privilege, y'all, for people to be able to talk to you. Remember that. When someone wants to mess with you, mess your day up, be like, it's a privilege that I even responded to you. So for you to try to ruin my day because you're having a bad day, not having it. So block, that block button is your best friend during this time, y'all, when people are trying to try it, okay? So that's my advice.
Block, 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 report, restrict, delete.
That's what I've been doing. And then lastly, it is so important that you are consuming beautiful Black art. Black joy. There are so many beautiful documentaries, movies, books, resources that are, you know, that show why Black culture is so beautiful. And a lot of times right now, we're seeing social media show this police brutality, which is important, but again, it's draining on our bodies. So to remember that our culture is beautiful, to remember that there is beauty within it and that there's a reason why we're fighting, we're marching, right? And to our white allies, again, it's important that you check on your Black friends. If you want to claim that Black friend when someone says you're racist and you're like, no, I got that one Black friend. Did you check up on them? Did you text them? And did you really text them because you want to be involved in their lives? Did you really text them because you want to follow up with them later? Are you creating spaces in your own homes? Creating spaces in your own job, in your businesses? Creating spaces in your community to provide change? What are you doing as a white ally, right? It's more than just a text, right? I had one of my friends from high school, like, hit me up and tell me like how she is with me, standing by me, and I appreciate it. And then she created this Facebook group for healthcare disparities and inequality with people who are underserved, mostly of color. I'm like, yes, sis, this is what we need, and being able to provide resources. You know, what are you doing as a white ally, as a person who's non-black? What are you doing a part of this movement? Because it helps us black people feel like our voices are being heard, right? And so it's important that you reach out to your black friends, and if they don't respond, don't take it offense. We're going through some times right now. We're going through a difficult time, you know? But it's important that we feel unity, that there's no division, that right now that we're being heard and that there's going to be actual sustainable change. And so I hope this video was informative. I hope you guys were able to take a little tips of things to do. Oh, one extra thing, books. It's so important to start reading, guys. I am in love with reading. Back in the day, I was like, oh, no, I'd rather watch a movie. I'd rather watch some Netflix, da, da, da. But opening a book and just being able to read and see that image happen in your head is super important. I just started doing this book club thing, and it's amazing. So definitely read certain articles that can rejuvenate your soul. Doesn't have to be about the Black Lives Matter movement, but it could just be about something that you're interested in, right? Anime, or just like, I don't know, something that's interesting that you want to do. Pick up a new hobby during this time. It really helps that you are taking care of your mental health during this time. I know that was a little rant in the end, but just wanted to put out there that it's important for us to just find things that make us happy, right? If it's going out, if it's...
going out, I don't know, we're still in coronavirus, but...
you know what I mean? The state's opening up here and there. Be safe, wear your mask, wear gloves, hand sanitizer, all that great jazz. You know, just exercising, doing the little things that make you happy. All right, see you guys for my next Medicine Monday video next week.